Now, this past weekend, I travelled over to Manchester, and I've just come back from Hebden Bridge, and these are the beers that I purchased and got this past weekend. First up, thanks to Ari Meadows and Ben Cunningham for, you know, drinking at the Manchester Beer Festival. But Ari gave me a beer. Six beers, I give him six drinks as well. This is from the Ari Meadows. This is Hermos Pelerus and the La Loco Moana. Hashtag Estolajana. Save the bell. Killer Cat and the Circus IPA. Bohemian Regent and the Czech beer. A shiny label. The Loose Cannon Brewery and the India Pale Ale. And Udog and the Hardcore IPA. So, we went to go to BeerMoth as well. The service was a bit poor, in fairness. The guy was more interested in the young lady. But I almost ended up didn't buy anything at all because of that service. But anyway, purchased two from Beavertown. One recommended by Rob Derbyshire, the Oldie Cowbell India Stout, the Smog Rocket Smog Porter, which I had before, nice beer, and the Runabock in the can. Not seen that before, so look forward to having that. Runaway Brewery and Smoke Potter. I think Adam Parker from Adam's Craft Beers speaks highly of this brewery. So I'll look forward to their beers. From Mad Atta, the Tea and Biscuit Mild. Because I wanted to purchase a lot of local beers. Not seen that before, so. From First Chop, the Passion Fruit Coffee Roasters Joe, cold brewed coffee IPA. Try and get the lights, anything else. From Black Jack and the Dragon's Tears. Jaspin Saison. From Blackjack, the Regal Stout. I'm guessing it's because it's due to being in the bag for a while. The label is this. Good. This is from Buxton Brewery and that Battle Horse, a double black IPA. Yeah, it wasn't like that, but it's been in my bag for 2 days. So. From the Bean Brothers Coffee Company, in collaboration with Squawk, another brewer. Bean Brothers is a coffee company in Manchester, I'm guessing. The sport is the brewing company in Manchester. So a coffee company and a beer company team together to brew this espresso stout. Again, the reason I purchased it was because it was local. Managed to purchase 10 via. Now, got to Hebden Bridge. Purchased a lot of these. A lot of these, and we're doing it at the same brewery, so. Offbeat brewery, dysfunctional IPA. I had it at the Manchester Beer Festival. Very nice. Cookie Gold from Offbeat. Outlandish Pale. I've had many of these beers before on tap, but I've never tried them on bottles, so that's pretty cool. Wacky Winter Warm. Hotball Red. Out of Step IPA. From Chromata, Brood Awakening. I've had so many times. From Chromata, the Cowabunga. Purchased it because it's Cowabunga, right? What else do you want to buy? Beaver Town Black Betty. Now, I was told this was a collaboration with Overton Ales and Offbeat, but it doesn't mention anything about Offbeat on here, but they are. Family name, Staffordshire, Canning Chase. Offbeat Ales is a cuckoo brewery, now at home in a nest in Crewe, Cheshire. But Offbeat Ales, this is a long ship, the smoke potter. A friend of mine, Lexis, just started a brewery, and luckily, a local bottle shop here in Yorkshire, The Drink, has purchased his range. Dirty Dog, it's a brown ESB. Submissible Anarchy, that's Juniper Winter IPA. I recall I've had that at the Nottingham Beer Festival. Bark Like a Bird, Red Rat. I've had this before on bottle, you've probably seen my review. But I also had it on cask recently. As in today. The Afternoon Sunshine, a dry hopped pale ale. And finally, the Kamikaze Op Parade 120 minute IPA. The beer festival was really good. Watch out for the video. Check out Drink in Hebden Bridge and check out BeerMoth. Just be prepared to wait a long time. Anything else? Oh yeah, check out Harry Meadows, his channel. Thank you for bringing those beers to me and looking forward to trying them. You take care.